I am Santosh Gadankar. Today I am teaching you mechanics of material. In that one, volumetric strain. Strain of a cylindrical bar. I am going to derive the volumetric strain of a cylindrical bar. Let us consider a cylinder. Along the axis, the force is applied in form of tensile. The distance between is length L, and we are referring this part as a diameter D. The figure shows a cylindrical bar of diameter D, length L, subjected to a tensile force P. Let delta L increase in length. Delta L will be the increase in length. As the tension is applied, the length will increase, the diameter will get reduced. Delta D decrease in diameter. Mu or 1 by m is nothing but Poisson's ratio. The final length of the bar, if you apply tension, the final length will be L plus delta L. Final diameter of the bar, diameter reduction occurs. Therefore, D minus delta D. The initial volume of the bar V is equal to pi by 4 into D square into L. If it is the area, then you have to take pi by 4 into D square. If it is a volume, you have to multiply with the length. Final volume of the bar is nothing but pi by 4 into D minus delta D whole square into L plus delta L. This is the final volume. That means diameter reduction occurs, in terms of length increase occurs. I am using a formula here. A minus B whole square, A square plus B square minus 2AB. I am going to apply over this part. Pi by 4 into D square plus delta D square minus 2D delta D into L plus delta L. Now multiply here. Pi by 4 L D square plus L delta D square minus 2 L D delta D. Next multiply delta L plus D square delta L plus delta D square delta L minus 2 D delta D, delta L. These are the product, cancel it out. This is the higher product, you have to cancel it out. Neglecting the smaller values. If you multiply the smaller value with the smaller value, the resultant will be again the smallest value. Therefore, we have to neglect it. Pi by 4 d square L minus 2 L d delta d plus d square delta L. This is the final volume. Now change in volume divided by delta V is nothing but final volume minus initial volume. Now substitute the values. What is the final volume? This is the final volume. Pi by 4 d square L minus 2 L d delta d plus d square delta L minus initial volume. Initial volume is, this is the initial volume. Pi by 4 d square L. Pi by 4 d square L. Pi by 4 d square L I will consider among these two, I will consider pi by 4 common. Pi by 4 d square L minus 2 L d delta d plus d square delta L minus d square L. D square L get cancelled. This is the change in volume. We got it. We know that volumetric strain EV is equal to delta V by V, change in volume divided by original volume. This is the change. We have obtained it. Otherwise, you can write one more time here. Delta V is equal to pi by 4 d square delta L. First I will write this time, next I will go for negative sign. 2 L d delta d. Now change in volume. Pi by 4 d square delta L minus 2 L d delta d divided by initial volume. Initial volume, this is the initial volume. Pi by 4 into d square into L. Pi by 4 d square L. Pi by 4 get cancelled. D square delta L divided by d square L minus 2 L d delta d divided by d square L. D square get cancelled. D and d get cancelled. L get cancelled. Delta L divided by L minus 2 delta D by D. This is the volumetric strain. Delta L by L we called as longitudinal strain. Delta D by D we called as a lateral strain. Lateral strain. Now we are going to write here in terms of longitudinal strain and lateral strain. ईवी इज नथिंग बट लॉन्जिट्यूडनल माइनस, इन प्लेस ऑफ दिस आई एम राइटिंग लॉन्जिट्यूडनल स्ट्रेन एंड माइनस टू इंटू लैटरल स्ट्रेन, टू इंटू लैटरल लैटरल स्ट्रेन lateral strain, lateral strain. We know that Poisson's ratio, we know that Poisson's ratio, ratio mu or 1 by m is nothing but lateral strain divided by longitudinal strain. Multiply here, cross multiply, longitudinal strain divided by m is nothing but lateral strain. Lateral strain is longitudinal strain divided by m, or longitudinal strain into mu, you can write it out. Now, in place of lateral strain, write longitudinal strain. This is longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain. In place of lateral, write longitudinal strain. Longitudinal strain minus 2 longitudinal strain divided by m. Take longitudinal strain common, strain common, it can be 1 minus 2 m. What is longitudinal strain? In place of longitudinal strain, write delta L by L. EV is equal to delta L by L, 1 minus 2 m. Or you can write as delta L divided by L, 1 minus 2 mu. This is change in length to the original length, which is nothing but strain in the x direction or in the L direction, 1 minus 2 mu, 2 divided by M. And we know that stress is directly proportional to the strain, and in order to remove the proportionality symbol, we introduce Young's modulus. Therefore, strain is nothing but stress divided by Young's modulus. Now, replace with this part. EV is equal to sigma divided by E, 1 minus 2 divided by M. This is the formula for volumetric strain for cylindrical bar. Or EV is equal to sigma divided by E, 1 minus 2 mu. I am Santosh Gaidankar. Thank you very much.